The Mocha Pro 2025 camera solver has some exciting updates. I'm Elizabeth Postol with Boris FX, and I'll show you how you can now solve moving objects in your scene. I'll also use the Mocha AI-powered math tools to get better results with a couple of clicks. So let's get started! This is the shot we'll work with. We have both the camera moving in space and multiple persons and moving objects within the scene. It's a great example to show you all the nuances when solving moving objects. My main goal is to track this double base into 3D space. Before we go into the camera tracking tab, we should tell Mocha what exact object you want to solve in 3D. Otherwise, Mocha will solve only the camera. There are a few ways to do this. We can use just the regular splines, the one that we usually use for masking and roto. In the track module, I select the X-spline tool and draw a loose mask around the double base, just like this. We do have an obstacle in the form of the player's hand that might potentially confuse the solving algorithm. So in order to get the best result, I can just avoid this area. We should have enough data from the other parts of the double base anyway. Then I can set up the surface, rename the layer, and perform a regular Mocha planar track. Now that I have that, let's follow to the camera solving module and see what happens. Before I click the solve button, a vital thing to do is to tell Mocha how the layers we've just created should be perceived. In Mocha 2025, you'll find columns that let you assign what you want a layer to do. We can solve it as a part of the 3D scene with the cog, use it as a garbage mask with the masking icon, or select the small moving cube icon and tell Mocha we want to solve this as a single moving object. Mocha Pro can only solve rigid objects that don't deform over time. Moving cars or screens are good. Talking human heads are not. So I switch the double base layer to the moving object mode and try to solve the camera. Uh-oh! Something went wrong. Mocha throws us an error that the scene could not be solved. Why is that? Well, let's look at the shot again. Besides the double bass that we want to track in 3D, we have three more musicians that also move in the space independently. All that extra motion confuses the solving algorithm as it processes the static scene. The character movement doesn't relate to the camera movement, so it's no wonder that Mocha gets confused. Let's help the solver to understand what is actually part of the static scene. I'll jump back to the planar track tab and draw a few more shapes. The classic Mocha workflow would involve drawing splines around each object that you want to isolate, then track each layer individually and make corrections along the way. We don't have to do any of that in Mocha 2025. The new Mask ML tool can help you save time and avoid the boring garbage mask part. Let's see the Mask ML tool in action. I'll start by creating a garbage mask for the sax player. Here in the toolbar, I select this object brush. With a few left mouse clicks, I can create a selection for the whole person and his instrument. However, if I play it back, the mat remains static. We have another great video that goes into detail about the new Mask ML tool. Check it out if you want to learn more. But for now, here's the quick steps you need to follow to make the mat animate across the clip. When you have made your selection with the object brush, choose the picker tool, and Mocha will automatically create a layer with the spline for the sax player. That already saves us time. Next, I head over to the new Mat tab and enable the checkbox Generate Object Mat. Notice here in the layers list, the sax player layer now has this tiny microchip icon. That indicates that the mat for this layer is now being generated with ML. The spline contour can also be extended or shrunk by adjusting the dilate parameter. Values around 15 to 20 usually works fine for the garbage mat. I'll click the render frame button to test it. That looks good. Now I'm 100% sure that none of the sax player movement will affect the camera. The only thing left is to click render forwards and enjoy the power of ML. In a few moments, you'll have the automatically generated mat. I'll repeat the same procedure for the piano player and drummer, and we can get back to the 3D camera solving. Now that I have that, I head over to the camera solve module again. Then in the layer list, I need to set the new shapes we've just created to the masking mode. This excludes them from the camera solve. If you don't know how this masking mode works, check out this other video about camera solving on our channel. You can find the link in the description. Let's try to solve again. With the solve complete, let's look at that in 3D space. It looks pretty good. However, sometimes you may get the moving object not quite fitting into the right place in the scene. Mocha's object solver is good, but it can't really tell if an object is very big and far away, or very small and close up. That can be easily adjusted with the object projection parameter. I'll change the viewer to left so we can see the general relative space where the double bass sits in the scene. Then I'll go up to the double bass layer in my 3D object panel and select it. I can then adjust the object projection so that it moves and scales into the right position. But for this specific shot, the double bass was solved just fine, so I'll undo the changes. The very last step is, of course, to export the scene to the software of your choice. You should not meet any troubles at this stage. However, once you click Export Camera, you might be surprised by the new export dialog. Don't be scared. All your favorite and needed export options are still there. We just reorganized them in a refreshed, more convenient list. Since we clicked the export button while being on the camera solving tab, Mocha automatically filters unrelated export options from the list. And the ones that you really need are right in front of you. Choose your options on the right-hand side of the panel, save it on a disk, and you're done. That's how you solve for a moving object in Mocha 2025. Hope this video gives you a good idea of how to start solving moving objects inside Mocha Pro. Subscribe to our channel and give us a like if you want to see more camera solve tricks. We really enjoy reading your comments, so let us know if you like the new camera solve module. My name is Elizabeth Postol. See you later!